Here we go again. When we left off last time, I was fighting an altogether very difficult enemy. And I've been doing some thinking. I think it's time to change some shit up. I'm talking, we got a new Great Ruin now. I think we keep the armor, keep the wolf head. I think we're gonna change weapons. But the thing is, what do I change weapons to? The scythe is really cool, but it requires 24 faith. Really, I really want a twin blade. But I don't have any twin blades. Two of these daggers. I guess I probably gotta leave here. Fine. Let me go to the other blacksmith that can help me out. War counselor EG. Damn it. So is that just the scabbard? Oh, it is. Okay. I see.
Ah, you finally come. Blythe told me everything. You've defeated General Radahn, unlocking the stars. The general was blighted by scarlet rot and driven to madness. But not long ago, he was hailed as the mightiest demigod of them all. There is no parallel to your achievement, nor to Lady Rani's acute judgment of character. Thanks to you, Lady Rani's fate once again stirs, and the path to Nokron has opened. Descend underground, where the fallen star struck Limgrave, and make it yours. The precious treasure of Nokron. Now the festival is over, and General Radahn is defeated, Jaren's duties are finally fulfilled. Though we served different masters, I could see he was truly adept in his role. Now the time has come to remind him of an old promise made. With the stars of fate set into motion, a certain sorceress is dispossessed of her immortality. Finally, we can be rid of a long-standing Carrion weed. Or, Blythe wanted me to tell you not to bother waiting for him and head straight to Nokron. Blythe has been given an important task. Apparently, a matter of great urgency. You need not await, Blythe. Descend underground alone, where the fallen star struck Limgrave, and make it yours. The precious treasure of Nokron, so that Lady Rani may tread the dark path of the Empyrean.
Hmm?
You need not descend underground, make it yours who that lead.
Okay. Iron steel dagger. Let's use one of these.
Something else.
Plus 8. So Blythe said he had a traitor to find. I'm gonna go back over there. I thought for sure the traitor would be the fucking dude. The mage. Sorcerer. Celibus? Something like that. There's a traitor taken care of. Onwards and Akron, then. Go on, I'll catch up. Let's head back down there and we'll do some investigating. Well, this is Nokron. The Eternal City. And I'm also still looking for the aqueduct, which this is the aqueduct. Maybe there's another way in. I didn't do a ton of investigating over here. Having a whole lot of knockback sucks. Gotta get used to it. I also don't have to fight those guys, so. Jellies. Hi, Jellies. Old thing. What's this? Silver tier husk. Aqueduct facing cliff. Okay. There's one of those fucking soldiers. One of those warriors.
Hello.
Oh. Let's go, you big bitch.
I'm just kidding.
Okay, may not be able to use the dagger for this. I wonder if I can give him the fall off. Cheese him up a little bit. Serve them up with some extra cheese. Certainly one of the worst parts is the tracking of these guys. Guys, let's not fight him, I suppose. Another one? It's in here. This guy will just stab you through the wall. Eh, maybe he'll fuck off. Chances? Unlikely. Find me, just gonna... What the fuck? You fucking asshole. Holy fuck. Look at that spear he's got. Oh, he's like a horned dude. He's like a horned version of those of that knight. Okay. Let's head back over there. Man, these like best laid plans. Remember when I was like, I want to go like get a new weapon and try it out. And now I'm fighting the fucking hardest enemies in the game, so I can't really do that. Inverted Hawk Tower Shield. Look at the arrows sticking out there. Order healing. And what's that? Alleviates death blight buildup. One of the incantations of the Golden Order fundamentalists used by hunters of those who live in death. Alleviates death blight buildup. The noble Gold Mask lamented what had become of the hunters. How easy it is for learning and learnedness to be reduced to the ravings of fanatics. All the good and the great wanted in their foolishness was an absolute evil to contend with. So I'm looking for D's little brother. I knew there were some dudes back there, or at least one. I didn't expect there to be four. Rank 4 smithing stone. Hello? Are you Dee's brother? Inner order. What if I do the... What if I snap my fingers at you? Still nothing, huh? I wonder what his problem is. Uh-oh. I'm not saying this looks like a boss fight or anything, but this kind of looks like a boss fight. Gargoyle. Valiant gargoyle. What the fuck? Ow. Like I hit him, unlike the goddamn moose. He's got a twin blade, though. Yeah, I suppose it wouldn't be a gargoyle fight without two of them. Switch it up to her. No, don't do it. Holy shit. Doing a shitload of damage to him. Okay. The one's got a twin blade. I think this has to be my next. bitch. Jesus Christ. Cool, dude. That guy's got other weapons too. God damn. Damn, damn, damn. I don't even know. Maybe this? Yeah, maybe the idea is fight the first guy down enough till the second guy spawns, then. I can't even tell where the poison's going. This guy's just helicoptering around. Thank you. How is it reaching all the way over here? Like, I don't know. I feel like I'm too weak to fight anything. Nothing does any damage. So. Okay, so I feel weak. That's D? I thought it was D's brother. I'm gonna head back. I really want to keep going that way because it seems like that's my best chance of getting Twin Blade from that gargoyle. But maybe not. With my luck, they'll drop the sword and the scythe. Okay, kind of feel like I'm spinning my wheels a little bit, and I shouldn't feel like that in a game this big. So I think I gotta change it up a little bit and go do something else. So that one lady said that next to the Grand Lift of Dectus was the area where there's another well over there. I think those are wells. Next to the Grand Lift of Dectus, you could go up to the mountains or up to the mount, whatever the hell it's called. So what I want to know is how to get up there. Is there like a horse jump thing over here? Roads and catacombs down there. See, there's like tons of ruins and shit up there. Nope. Don't know how to get there right now, so I'm not gonna stress about it too much. So we're gonna go over here to the Grand Lift of Dectus. And the lady said that there's a valley over here I can go into. Yeah, down there, that's the valley. Okay. Maybe the whole thing here is a valley. Oh, that's like Insanity Tower up there. Maybe it's the other way. Didn't think about that. I suppose I could always go visit her again, see what she says. There's like a hidden passage. Way maybe. Thank you. bitch. Cuckoo Knight. Now, what doesn't make any sense to me is why I can't have my torch out when I'm on my horse. Like, that goes back to Doom 3. You couldn't have a gun and a flashlight out at the same time. Nice. The ravine. Well, let's take the ravine all the way through. Smith and Stone. Anyone here? Ravine Vale Village. Or, as they know it, the locals know it, RVV. What was that? Hello? Sounds very deliberate. Oh, he's mining. Like magic, do you? Give me those smithing stones, though. I'll take those off your hands.
Motherfuckers trapped this place? Seems rude. And they call it a mine. A mine! Explosive stone clump and a pickaxe. Lightning grease. Oh my god. Those guys just hiding in the wall there. Sneaky bastards. Somber smithing stone. Rune-strewn precipice. Rune-strewn precipice. Resto. Soft cotton. That was a fucking brutal black backslash. Oh yeah, somber smithing stone right before. know what I should actually do. I must have, like, oh, God. All I have is that? I don't have just a regular-ass bow? Okay, never mind. I was like, gonna say, I could use a regular-ass bow to knock some of those guys down. Apparently not. Not if I don't have one. I don't know why the bats sing. Oh God, I don't want to die here. I'm actually kind of looking forward to getting that spear. Maybe I'll just use the spear for a while, because, man, kind of miss having some distance on my weapons. More singing. Must be above me. Lucky. Thought for sure I was dead. Two of them. course I can't fucking hit him. I swear to God, this game is just unhittable enemies. It's all over now. I guess this is the game though when you play with the X build. Short weapons. I've hardly hit anything. But when you do, you hit them real fast. You just can't fucking reach anything. Boss. Rune strewn precipice overlook. Rune strewn. Ruin strewn. And that's a boss. Is it gonna be a giant ass bat? Who the hell's that? Is that the, a cool looking room. This is gonna be the whole fight. He's got a sword too. I'm so far under this motherfucker, I can't even see him to hit him. I feel like it's my problem with every fucking boss. Just beat his ass. Like, my camera was pointing straight up. Dragon heart. Another one? Magma worms, scale sword. I'll just go ahead and assume that that's not a twin blade. Curved greatsword. Ah, faith and dex. More strike, though. Curved greatsword wielded by magma worms. The shape resembles a dragon's jaw and is covered in heart scales. It's said these land-bound dragons were once human heroes who partook in dragon communion, a grave transgression for which they were cursed to crawl the earth upon their bellies, shadows of their former selves. Unique skill, magma guillotine. Grab the scale sword with both hands as a worm would hold it in its mouth and leap forwards, smashing it into the ground and triggering a blast of magma. Follow up with an additional input to perform a chopping attack. Cool. Souls. A little bit closer to our faith goal. Actually, I might just go for it. What if I use one of these? Make 24,000. Now I can use this fucking thing. This fire damage. Counterattacks unique to thrusting weapons. That's fucking cool. Oh, it gives me madness too. The war spear singed and blistered by fingers used by Vike and Knight of the Round Table Hold. Like Vike himself, it is tormented by the yellow flame of frenzy from within. Couple things I want to do. First, I want to go talk to Kale and see if he sells a bow.
Ah, always a plan.
He does not.
Goodbye.
Okay. Oh, this uses somber smithing stones. Okay. That's competing with 147 plus 70. This is 133 plus 112. But it's also 94 plus 16. So we have a bit of who else might sell? A bow. K.
Castle Morn Rampart guy.
Trade again.
Crossbow. Light crossbow. But not a bow. Oh shit, I guess I didn't even look at that. Let's go back to the round table hold real quick. Winged great thorn. Distinctive horns suffused with the power of ancestral spirits. This large wing-shaped specimen is wielded as a weapon of spirit worship. In the ancestral spirit worshiping faith, these are considered envoys' wings, made to reap the lives of beings which experience no sprouting. Unique skill, soul stifler. Stifler. Stifler is the guy from American Pie. Raise the great thorn's wings to summon a soul-sapping miasma. Enemies in the affected area will temporarily suffer from reduced defense. I don't want a great bow, I just want a regular ass bow.
Now.
Hey man, I found your brother, I think? Apparently you don't care. Or apparently I don't care to tell you.
Well, I took you for no matter to lay out your own.
Damn, I don't have a rank 6 one. Look at how much damage it does now, though. I dig it.
Can you dig it?
These are all heavy loads. That's a good load.
Magma worm Makar.
Let's give it a whirl. It's a dope ass looking spear. Touched by flame. Flame. Dear flame. We're going all the way up. Altus Plateau. We fucking made it. And I got an invitation. Abandoned coffin.
Very large area up here. Sacred Order, Ashes of War. Ruins. Ruins are one of my favorite things. Cause there's fun shit to find. Hello? Miranda powder. Ooh. A little cave down here. Two of them. Unsightly catacombs. These don't look good at all. Haft axe. That was fucking cool. Something unnerving about this music. That like dissonant note being hit. No horse ahead. I like this spear. Jumping required ahead. Wicked sword ahead. Know what he meant by a wicked sword. Hidden path ahead. Liar. I forget I have this lantern. Oh.
Horsehead. Send these fools on fire with my winged misbegotten ashes. Well, that's one of these things. There's the switch. Somewhere, I wonder. Runart, nice. Prattling Pate. Apologies. What? Emits a voice that says, apologies. Twisted clay sculpt in the shape of a human head emits a voice that says, apologies. A wistful fetish that imparts voices and words on the eternal journey.
Apologies.
I mean, it sounds like Satan himself. How many more misbegotten warriors must I fight? Oh, and I go all the way back here. Yeah, fuck that. Apologies, but I'm not doing that. Thank you. Holy fuck. Perfume bottle. Omen killer robe, omen killer long gloves, and omen killer boots. Did we just find a new armor set? Perfumer's cookbook. What the fuck? Glass bottles used by perfumers used to seal various scent compounds, crafting perfume items. The art of perfuming was once jealously guarded in the capital, but after the perfumers were drafted into service during the shattering, the art became widely practiced throughout the lands between. Budding cave moss. Another perfume bottle. Oh my god. Oh. Miss me with that shit. Oh, that follow-up. Another perfume bottle back here. Poison bloom, Miranda powder, nascent butterfly. So what the fuck kind of perfumes can I make? Perfumes? Teleport me away. Perfumer's talisman. Okay. It's so, like, it's interesting because it's weird to be this late into the game and they're still introducing mechanics. Your perfume. Spark aromatic. Uses FP to scatter sparks in a wide area. Boosts ally attack power. Reduces incoming damage once. Grant me a couple of those. Oh, I want to look at that gear. It's in the same omen killer robe.
Gives me more immunity. Less overall damage protection. Well, that's a little bit lighter. Oh, I dig it. I think we found us some new robes, at least for now. It may not be the best, but sometimes it's okay to just look cool. Like a big old poison lake or what? Sage's cave. Yeah, it's a sage's cave. Of course there's going to be a hidden wall. What the fuck? Fooled me. Rest up. Okay, I'm not gonna fall or jump into the fucking water this time. See his last time. Lost Ashes of War. Rejuvenating Boluses. Bolo. Boli. Which one's the mimic? none of them, huh? Just like armor set. Ace and butterfly. Candle tree wooden shield. Black hood, dope. Silver pickled fowl foot. Oh, wait. And then we go back to the confessor gear. Yep. Well, we had new armor for a very short time. Christ. Okay, I'm dead. I'm not like you guys, man. I don't have to fucking... You don't have to kill me two or three times. You know what I'm gonna do, though? Oh, I don't know it. I was thinking I'll just, use that gear or use that spell that makes it so I don't have to kill these guys more than once. Even when I get more... Fuck me, man. How did I manage to do that in that small area last time? I guess I just kept attacking and they just died. Thank you, that guy's attention. Come here, you big bitch. Oh my fucking god! I didn't get my souls anyway. Yeah, fuck you.
Hey guys. Fucking later, bye. Yeah, what are you gonna do now, bitch? A fucking boss on top of all that. Raptor's black feathers. What? And skeletal mask. Holy shit. Holy fuck. Oh, fucker. That was a weird noise I made. And I don't think I unlocked any shortcuts or anything, so. Fucking stutter step bullshit. And I'm dead. Damn. Just can't quite make it over there. Oh no. Oh, the burn's definitely coming out.
Here's where I die.
Fuck you, Necromancer Garrus. Family heads. Oh my god, is that a twin blade? It's a flail. Fuck! No!
Three bludgeoning copper heads attached to a handle by chains. Signature weapon of Necromancer Garrus, the heretical sage. The heads were made to resemble those of his wife and two children. Gross.
Unique skill, Familial Rancor. Gently rattle the copper heads to summon vengeful spirits that chase down foes. The anguish of a spouse and children invites accursed wrath.
Damn.
Raptor's black feathers. Robe crafted from with the black feathers of a bird of prey, worn by the assassins of Ravenmount. A ritual implement for transforming into a death bird, if only by imitation. Strengthens jump attacks. We are birds of prey, bringers of death.
Shit. A skeleton mask. And a bird of prey. pop it in there. Okay, so now I just gotta find a map. Hello? I didn't feel like my jump attack was enhanced, but I also don't jump attack too often, so. How would I even know? This must be Mount Gelmir. Mount Gelmir. These are all coffins. Ruler's mask and ruler's robe. Mask in the image of a wizened sage. Customary dress among lords in a smaller nation. Increases faith. Such a mask illustrates the qualities of an ideal lord, chiefly wise and possessing a certain defined geniality. One at the center of society often finds these qualities most expedient. Luxurious robe worn by lords in a smaller nation. Its fine blue mantle serves to prove its wearer's status. Fuck that. I got a lot of souls loose here. The beast eye quivers. Oh, there's a mariner here. Hello, mariner. Thank you. cut that shit out. Where'd you go, bitch? Oh, fuck. Nope. Don't want anything to do with that guy. She's way up there? That's not even water up there. What the fuck? Tibia's summons. Check them out. Human bone shard. Not altogether surprising. Just walk up and give him a smack. Hey. Do I want to do this again? Didn't I just get done fighting a bunch of these fuckers? Hopefully this is just a treasure chest. It's not. Well, I mean, it might, maybe it is, but... gonna teleport me too. Pearl Drake Talisman plus one. Which one is that one? Greatly boosts non-physical damage negation. I can dig that. Side of grace. Good. Now I'm gonna go visit the Beastial Sanctum and be done. Oh, actually, I'm gonna go get this first. I get faith to 20. What's Melina got to say?
The Erd Tree is close, only a little further till the foot of the Erd Tree, and the accord is fulfilled. It takes me back. I was born at the foot of the Erd Tree, where Mother gave me my purpose. Though now, everything is lost to me. I have to ascertain for myself the reason for which I live, burned and bodiless.
Huh. I'm pretty close to the Erd Tree, but there's no way I'm not, like, I've still got so much shit to do. I got so much more of this area to explore. I've barely explored it. But definitely, that may be what I do next. So I got that boss over there, too. First, we're going to go to the Bestial Sanctum. Turn in my death weed. Death root? Death weed? Death root.
I am not sated.
Bestial Vitality. What's that? Heals HP over a period of time. Fills the body with bestial vigor, restoring HP over a period of time. Having gained intelligence, the beasts must have felt how their wildness slipped away as civilizations took hold. Oh, there's a fucking sight of grace down here. Fucking dragon right there. Farum Great Bridge. Fucking tower over there that I want to go check out. Dragon's like, are you fucking kidding me? Yeah, buddy. I'm not here for you. I want to go see what's up. Who do you think you're fighting up there, man? Lens Rise? Okay, there's another one of those rises that I know nothing about, but we'll have to figure it out another time. God, our character looks good.